So the real thing is, me and Ben have always talked about how we want to do a drunken podcast.
This is it.
This is it.
Hey, there we go. Why do I have to be a part of this?
But I want.
You're the star, Mandy.
You are the star, Mandy.
Yeah.
Mandy's the star. So everyone who's listening,
Oh
God. Alright, what's up everyone? Welcome back to Apartment Shenanigans. This is Avery, and I'm here with Ben.
Hi guys.
And we are also here with some friends, Mandy and Justin.
Hey, what up?
Hi.
And today we're actually going to be talking about some random topics, some different quirks that Ben and I have thought up of and whatnot. But that friends know.
So originally this was supposed to just be like the two of us or like the two of us and like Kim and Victor, where we were like, oh, I knew like Avery
likes this.
So like Avery likes the
okay, don't say anything just yet.
When we first moved in, Avery would like walk into the kitchen when I'm like cooking breakfast or whatever and just be like like making random ass chicken noises or whatever, or like dinosaur noises, and that's like the basis of like our friendship right there. Is like, if you need to know like a 10 second like how Ben and Avery are friends and why, like that's why.
Which I think you were sending someone a Snapchat before. You're like, say hi, and you just pointed the camera to me. I was just like, meh. I didn't say a word. I just like right. waved. They're like, that's about right.
Bring the good old Q Holdor thing.
Right.
Oh my God.
So like literally the basis of everything.
So yeah, it was like, let's talk about different weird quirks and things that we do that some people might not know about each other. But then we were saying, let's name the other person's weird right. quirks.
So like I would say Avery's quirks and Avery would say mine, because I don't necessarily know every single like weird thing that I do. Like I know, because I'm left-handed, I put the like spoon rest for the stove on the left side, which we had a conversation about like when we had first moved in, like not a like actual fight, but like he's like, why do you keep moving the spoon rest to the left side? And I'm like, I'm left-handed, so like that makes sense. And he's like, oh, okay. And it's just stayed on the left side ever since. So like that was as simple as that. But like, I don't even know.
Just random
besides
crap
that, I don't know what other random little things that we've run into. Besides like, oh, I don't tend to like, he tends to think of like cleaning before I do. But like, so if we were, so I like, I'm thinking, oh, let's clean Saturday. He'll be like, and I'll be like, oh, Saturday afternoon after I wake up and I've been awake and like eat breakfast and like kind of get like coffee or whatever. Mm. And he'll be like, when we wake up, he'll be like, can you do the dishes? And I'm like, that was on my like to-do list for today. It was just scheduled for like 2 o'clock. And you're asking me at like 11 o'clock in the morning. Like, we end up lining up like that, like, basically on
numerous
the same,
times.
Like, all constantly. Like, both of us are tired of the shit that's like dirty in the apartment or whatever. But like, he's like just slightly more urgent than I am on the dishes that are piled up in the sink or whatever, or like, I don't know, he never uses my bathroom, so like that's not a big deal.
Yeah, but he's like, when it comes to like cleaning the apartment, it's more so like if it is the dishes, I'll be like, oh, can you do the dishes? And you're like, yeah, sure. But then if I ask
like,
him to,
my
he,
plan
he
is
will.
Usually, so when he asks me, he means like, can you do them now? And my plan is like, yes, I'll do them today. Mm-hmm. But that today might be like 2 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
The next day, like when I plan, like,
they will
oh,
get
I'll do
done.
Them after work. But he's thinking like, oh, can you do them before work? And I'm like, no, I can't.
which
I mean,
like,
yes, I can, but
like
that would indicate me having to like kind of quote unquote rush according to me. Whereas he's like, yeah, like you have this time in the morning before you go to work because you don't work till like noon, so like just do them then. And I'm like, but I'm like showering and drinking coffee and like doing nothing before work, and then I'll do it after work. Whereas you're, but that's just based on the fact that like you're more of a morning person than I am.
Which at the same time, it's not like it hasn't caused like a problem.
No, we've never like actually had like a relationship like type of like fight about it. We're just like, yeah, we were both thinking, yeah, we should probably clean this place. It's kind of dirty. Like on the same day, it's just like he thought 10 o'clock and I thought like 2 o'clock.
So anyway, that's not even really a weird quirk. It's just more so
different. That's just like you and I that like we kind of run into.
But no, some random things. I actually did ask Mandy about it a few weeks ago. Random quirks. I made a small list, and gosh,
I'm interested to see if she knows anything that I know or that I do.
Mandy did tell me something, and I was like, I don't get that. But before I get to that, like one specific thing was there's. You just did it, like the little cough you do.
Mm-hmm.
Like you always do that. It's not even like a little cough. It's like
I didn't say that.
Did it's almost like a sympathy thing, right?
It's like you'll like you just cough. I'm not sure if you cough because you actually had a cough, but like sometimes you'll just even do like a like it doesn't seem like it's needed, mm-hmm. but you just do it because like it's almost a reaction of something. I don't know.
It could be.
It's a weird cough. Next time you do it, I'll point out it. You will do it again.
So, like, our, like, family thing is, like, it's considered, like, the smoker's cough. It's, like, because my mom does the same thing.
I got the black lung pop.
Right. I guess. Like, but it's just like
you've been down the mine for 5 minutes. What are you doing?
So it's just like because like my mom and I and like all of us have like some form of like heartburn or like acid reflux type of thing. So like you cough like in general because like that's apparently like the normal reaction to like something kind of burning in your throat. Like it's a little tickle, but it's not like enough to where you're like. It feels like it's burning or like it hurts, but it's just like this sort of like tingle in your throat type of deal.
Mm-hmm. I guess. So I don't know.
That's just what we call it. So like it's just solely like our own like family like thing. And it's just this like dry sort of like sympathetic asking for sympathy type of talk where you're like, hey. And it's like,
please tell me I'll be okay.
Right. Yeah. But it's not like at least for me, it's not like I'm asking for that. It's just like, I kind of like feel a little tickle in my throat. But like, if I cough, it kind of feels better.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't necessarily actually physically feel better. It's just like, almost like a compulsion to do.
One other thing that, like, when I did ask Mandy about it was, she said this, which
I'm
had
very interested to see what she told you. I do saying. As far as weird quirks.
I had no idea what she was talking about, but specifically, she said some kind of hand high five thing that he does when he's driving.
Yeah.
And I had no idea what she was talking
I'm
about.
I'm very
like,
confused.
Like, what,
still don't know.
Like when I'm driving with you in the car.
Like, man,
when you're just driving normally.
And I'm like.
So, he just like.
Yeah, like all the time.
Like a
just
fist
watch
bump? And
no,
it, like,
it's like you're like.
A high five.
That's not a high five. This
yes,
is like.
It is.
This is like you're turning the lights on in sign language.
I know it is.
Just wait. You'll see.
Like,
is it something like when I'm like talking and I'm like rambling
no,
and
you're
I'm
not
like.
It's
driving
like
something.
Talk to the hand. Like, that's what you're doing. Talk to the hand.
Yeah.
Like, that doesn't. I've never seen him do that.
Just
I don't
watching.
Even know what you're talking about. I feel like maybe it's just something between you and I's relationship where I'm like, stop talking, don't
yeah,
talk. Like, don't talk to me.
No, you'll watch.
Stuff while he's driving to get him mad to him, just wanted to do like,
well,
Mandy, just be quiet. And he just puts out your face.
No. You just go,
I mean,
like,
yes, what you said is accurate, but like, I don't necessarily know that I like give her the like, 12-year-old, like, talk to the hand.
Yeah, so that's what Mandy said, and I've been trying
that's
to...
a weird thing.
That's
like,
the only thing I could think of.
See, this is why I wanted to ask other people, like, because that's something I would have never known that I did.
Yeah.
But, like, I guess, because I am very, like, I talk with my hands. And,
oh, yeah,
like,
I
as
did
we drove
that.
To work
mm-hmm.
and stuff, like, singing along or whatever we were talking about.
I mean, I just sing the songs like, in general. So.
Well, yeah, but you like notice I like talk with my hands more and stuff, especially like if I'm driving. Like I kind of like, I don't know, I do random like gestures and stuff. Like the bubbles today, you know?
Dude,
like,
that was so what were we talking about?
I don't even know, but I was talking about bubbles and like carbonation. Yeah. And I did it this way instead of like this, like they're rising.
I mean,
up.
Even if you did like this, like, did it really make sense to me?
No, I know. Like, and like in my head, for some reason, this meant bubbles coming up.
Like this, I don't even know how you could describe what this is.
This is the fizzing of the bubbles. But like, not that anybody listening can see, but like, I just was like. And I don't know like, how to get this point across.
I feel
like
you're doing like little. You're doing
this is like when you and I play like anything that has to do with guess what I'm telling you without telling you what it is.
Dude, what happened yesterday?
Oh, that's right.
That happened yesterday.
What did I say? I was saying something, and you were like, "Oh, that's," and you got it like dead on. And I didn't even say what it was, anything remotely, and I just like pointed to you, and you were like, "Yes," like. Thought well, locked
was it like
in
a movie
like,
or something that we're
yeah,
talking about?
It was like a quote from a movie or something, and you were like locked into my like train of thought. It's like it was nothing like oh,
related
I
to
mean,
what we're talking
spaghetti
about.
With a fork. Like I was just like blah 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 blah, and I like pointed to him like that's not what I did, but like he's like oh that's from like you know whatever it was.
It's from Moana.
Yeah.
Like oh yeah,
exactly.
You're right. Thanks.
Like,
man.
I was like this, and he's like. You're welcome. Like, he just knew the song. I mean, that's not what it was, but, like, that's basically what it was. I just, like, pointed to him,
what
and
it
he
was
knew
exactly.
Exactly what it was. And I was like, this is why you're my charades or any type of guessing game partner.
Gosh, okay. So, I don't think you've made, like, wrote anything down, but, like, weird, I mean, I know you have a ton of weird things you even mentioned to your mom, like, weird quirks that I do.
Yeah, bro, you do so many, Avery. Like, so many. So, it's literally, like, you know, you switch from, like, you know, from, like, one personality to another, like, on a
yes.
dime, like, so
yes.
quickly.
Like, you'll be having a serious conversation
yeah.
yes. with, like, the normal Avery, and then, like, just whatever will trigger him, he'll switch and be, like, break out into, like, show tunes, like, Broadway,
yeah.
like, singing and dancing Avery, and then once he finishes, like, the chorus, he'll immediately
he's back,
switch
he's such
back.
A nerd Avery, you got nerd Avery coming in here, this is all you care about, is just, then switches again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or, like, just, the just, random, like oh. I said earlier, like, the random, I would be, I, honestly, I remember once. I don't even know if it was specifically one day, but, like, I was making eggs or something in the kitchen, and you, like, walked in to the kitchen and, like, tried to surprise me, but you, like, made this dumb chicken. You know, right? You made this dumb chicken noise, and you were like, and I was like, what are you doing? But this was, like, immediately after I had woken up, like, I hadn't had, like... The water was still boiling for coffee. Like, I had, like, I woke up and I was like, man, I am really hungry. So I started making coffee and eggs. And, like, I was not even awake. And you just walked in.
Just you a good
and we're like,
do right there.
You were, like strutting
like,
yourself. Like, you put your hands under your armpits.
No,
and you were like, and you were, like, making dinosaur noises or something. And I was like, you startled me. Like, this was like, when we first moved in, like within the first month, and I just looked at you and I was like, what are you doing? And you were like, nothing. Like, you immediately snapped back to reality and we're like, just like, oh, hey, good morning. And I'm like, okay, whatever. And I just continued making whatever, and we just ignored like it never happened.
No, like, the weirdest thing I do with noises is definitely just when I like, stub my toe, which you've...
Literally, anytime you're in any sort of, like, non, like, actual pain, you just sound like an anime dad yelling at their kid.
If we're talking about noises, can we talk about the way you snore?
Dude, I've never really heard him snore.
How have you not heard that?
Well, other than him, like, sleeping on the couch, which is just, like, him
Avery like, has the loudest, heavily. Most obnoxious snore. Like, you swear that this man dies in the middle of his sleep.
So, that's comes what...
back to life. Like, is baptized, but then also, like, sent to, like, freaking, like, hell, and then rises again. Like, it's like, what is happening?
So that's what it sounds like when you were just when you had passed out on the couch with and Kim and Victor were there, and I missed this entire thing, and you were asleep on the couch, and Kim and Victor tried to wake you up before they left, and they didn't do it because they didn't know to like fucking try to like kill you before you woke up, and they were like, hey, wake up. I literally pictured it, and they were like, hey, Avery.
Yeah, they're like, we tried pushing you.
And at this point, we had been, we had lived together, like, six months. And I was like, are you serious? You tried to wake him up just by, like, gently pushing his shoulder? If he was generally, like, asleep, yeah, that probably would have worked. Because you're generally a light sleeper. Like, I can knock on your door, like, open it and be like, hey, wake up, we gotta go to work.
Mm-hmm.
But, like... if you were drunk, like, I would know to, like, push you off the couch, like,
which I wouldn't or,
like,
even get mad at.
Slap you like, and, like, wake you up. Like, I would have to, like, basically physically harm you to wake you up.
Rachel has told me she's covered my mouth and my nose, and I didn't wake up.
What? And, yeah. Like,
I don't wake up. Like, I'd stop like, breathing. Like, I would
have to force you to
and
be
then
awake.
I'll eventually, she, like, stopped me. She was worried. And eventually, when she stopped, when she, like, I was like... Like, I was still asleep.
Yep.
Like,
yep.
Right. So, like, at this point, we had been living together long enough that I already knew that. But apparently, Kim and Victor didn't. And so they were just like, Avery, hey, wake up. And I was like, when they were telling me the story, I'm like, are you serious? The dude was asleep. One, on the couch. Two, he had been, like, he had broken up with, like, you know, who, like, the significant other. And then, like, he was pretty drunk, so, like, you gotta do a little more than, like, hey, just gently wake him up. Like, it's not like, you know, hey, you might be late for work. It was like, look, dude, you have to wake up because there's somebody in our house. Like, that's the kind of level you had to be on to wake you up. And they were mad that you didn't wake up and be like, oh, drive safe. I was like, are you serious? Like... I come home from work and the dude's asleep on the couch and I like kick his arm really hard to wake him up and he's like, oh, and then like rolls over in the time that it takes me to go to the bathroom and change into my PJs and come back out and he's snoring on the couch again and I just like turn the lights off and go to bed because I'm like, this guy's not waking back up again until he wakes up on his own and goes to bed. Because it was, like, already, like, 2:00. Like, whatever, man, I'm just going to go to bed and leave you on the couch because... You're an adult. You can sleep. You can sleep wherever you want. I don't care. As long as you're not like, even if you ended up in my bed, I would be like, all right, I guess I'm sleeping with Avery tonight. Like, whatever.
You want to sleep in your bed or my bed?
No, but if you ended up in my bed, and if you like, instead of like walking to your room, you just ended up in mine, I'd be like, all right, I guess we're sleeping together. Because, oh, like, I wouldn't go to sleep in your bed because that'd be too far for me to walk and I'm lazy. And you'd be like, I'd cover you up with a blanket and be like, I hope he doesn't, like, wake me up or push me out of the bed. Just, like, let you sleep
there.
Oh,
God. Anyway. Oh, gosh. I was not expecting you to bring up my snoring.
Bro, that shit was so annoying the first time. I could not sleep the first time I let over. I'm like, bro, I'm like, Avery, can you just, like, you know, not snore like this, like, please.
What yeah, like, let me just over. Let me just not snore.
Like, if he's on his back, you have to roll him over onto his side.
For sure.
Yes, you stop snoring if you sleep on your side.
Really? Yeah.
Yes. Because when,
how did,
so
how
when
did
I was saying,
figure that
like,
out?
Because I rolled you over onto your side so you'd shut up.
You're so loud.
Because, like, when you fell asleep on the couch and your arm was sticking out,
yeah.
Like, and I kicked it to wake you up when I had gotten home from work. And then, like, I came back from putting my PJs on, and I walked back into the living room, and you were asleep like this in the corner of the couch after you had woken up and been like, oh, hey, dude, how was work? Like, had a full regular conversation for, like, 5 minutes. And I went to the bathroom and changed and, like, came back out, and you were asleep on the couch snoring, and I was like, all right. And I, like, I don't know if I, like, got something to eat or whatever, and I came back out into the living room again, and you were, like, sprawled all over the couch again on your back snoring, and I was like, all right, I'm just gonna, like, go to bed. I turned the lights out. Like, I didn't even look to see if you had a blanket. I just went to bed. And then that's when you were like, oh, yeah, I went to bed at, like, 6 o'clock in the morning or 5 o'clock. Because I woke up on the couch, and I'm like, yeah, because I woke you up twice, and you didn't go to bed. So I was like, all right, this guy's just going to sleep on the couch for the night, so whatever. I mean, I don't care. The couch was free. Like, you're not breaking a brand new couch that you and I paid for, so whatever.
Anyway.
And you looked comfortable, so I was just like, whatever, I'll just lay sleep.
See, I was thinking you're going to mention either... Because you mentioned this to your mom, was the way I, like, pack my clothes and make sure I have all the clothes.
I almost mentioned that today. And also, and I tried to, but then, like, the conversation just immediately changed.
And then also, like, the way I eat my food, weird. Like,
you eat it weird?
I eat everything in, like, proportions.
Oh, yeah. You take, like, a bite of each and you rotate through, like... So if you have, like, vegetables, potatoes, and, like, a protein, like a meat or something, you take a bite of each... And then you rotate back around. So you eat, like, meat, potatoes, broccoli, or whatever in a circle.
What gets tricky, though, is if I have, like, a really big steak, but not that much potatoes. I would have to eat enough of the steak. You
gotta balance it.
Yeah, I have to eat enough of the steak until I get to the amount of steak with potatoes.
Right. But then you're like, oh, what do I like the most when you get to, like, a very small amount of what's left? Then you're like... What's my favorite flavor? And then you save that for last, and you eat all the other stuff, and then eat the last bite, so you end on a good note. And I'm like...
But that's normal. I've talked to other people about that.
That is not normal.
It is normal.
No. Because this steak is too good. I just want to end on this, and then go to sleep.
I have something like... It's like, okay, you know, this is really good, and I want to end on that. That's like my last thing.
But the thing is,
I don't proportion it, like, as much as that.
But because I proportion everything...
No, he is super picky.
Because I proportion everything... I cannot have someone have the last bite of something because they'll throw everything off. So if someone has, like, the first bite, the middle bite, whatever, I'm cool with that. But if they took the last bite, I'm like, why would you take that from me?
Right. You get, like, first in the
league. You're that person who takes the last slice, like, of pizza out of the box.
Right? Oh, that doesn't matter. No, that's fine. But if I have my pizza, a milk, like, I like pizza and milk. That's what we're coming
what?
In. Yeah, I know.
Don't ask me. How did that happen?
How the hell did that happen?
I don't know that.
No, I don't know that.
We've made frozen pizzas before.
Yeah, we've made pizza. I don't ever notice you drinking milk with it.
He's definitely... So
what, you're, like, dunking the pizza in milk and shit, like, it's cooking?
No, not that much. I'll just, like, drink it with it. It's just a combination.
So, like, the normal is, like, pizza and beer, like, pizza and wine, or some sort of alcohol. But, like, if there's not that, he'll just drink pizza and milk. To me, that's not that big of a deal, because growing up, like, it was milk or water for dinner, and then, like, Friday nights was, like, or Saturdays was, like, the soda night when we would get, like, McDonald's or, like, and we could have one soda a week. So that was, like, our special, like, treat.
But, yeah, like, that's just always been my
thing.
So
it's not super weird for me.
Milk is just strictly breakfast for me. Like, it's, like, anything after breakfast, like, no milk. Like,
but, see, the thing is, like, going back to the proportion thing, like, specifically, like, sushi. So, like, sushi.
I've noticed with the sushi, like, that.
You've noticed
with the sushi? Yeah, I've definitely noticed with the sushi. Yeah. Because so, like, I honestly I do that too with sushi, where it's
I totally do it too.
If I get a different amount of sushi, it's like, you know, I gotta do one, another.
Right, because if you get a couple different rolls, you're like, one might be four pieces, one might be six.
That bothers me. It messes everything up.
When I eat sushi with Pat, we used to go to All You Can Eat Sushi all the time in Salisbury, and, like, he would get, like, let's say four rolls at a time, and he would just eat one whole roll.
No, then another roll. No,
I'm like,
you can't do that. No.
What are you doing?
I'm like, I want to mix it up so I get, like, different flavors, but then I'm like, oh, I have one that has eight pieces, one that has six, and one that might have four.
Another thing you might not know, though, is when I do order sushi, I try to get one spicy roll at the very least. And when I do eat that, I try to like balance out my proportions.
I didn't know you specifically try to get something spicy.
I always try to get one spicy, and then like two other rolls right. that aren't spicy. Usually.
But then that's the thing is, like some special rolls come with eight, but like this place in our apartment, all rolls come with eight pieces. But usually, yeah, like special rolls will be eight, normal rolls will be six. So I'll be like, oh man, I had to eat two of these special rolls to get everything up with six pieces. Mm-hmm. And then I get up to six pieces, then I'll be like one, two, three, four, and alternate.
Yeah.
But then the thing is, if I get a special roll, you just like, it's a special roll, so it's really good. Mm-hmm. So I want that to be like the last bite.
So he wants it to be the last thing he remembers. Exactly. In case he dies, he wants to go out with a bang.
Not in case I die, but taste, like...
The
point's the same.
With sushi especially, I'm kind of the same with that.
But like I'm the same with like everything. If I have a burger, I have a fries, I have a milkshake, I'll eat the burger, but like say they give me like a whole boatload of fries. I'll try my best to eat so many fries to get to the same proportion in my head as the burger. And if I can't
Watched you do that. And it kind of in all honesty, it's kind of annoying because like I'll basically be done eating, and this guy will still be trying to, like, figure out the proportion, like, oh, I'm gonna eat 2.5 fries this time, and then, like, a small bite of burger, and I'm just like, can we be done yet? Like, we've been here for, like, 2 hours, like, we're just eating a cheeseburger and fries.
Like, the hardest thing is, like, trying to balance your drink with it, too.
Yes, I know, because it's like you're like at least like if it's not like soda or water where there's like free refills if we're like at a bar or something.
Oh, what like, really actually kind of gets on my nerves, which is kind of like what kind of gets on my nerves, like which is kind of messed up and rude of me, is if I'm proportioning everything perfectly and then the waiter will come by with a refill. I'm like, oh god,
oh no,
it messes everything up. Yeah. Yes, I definitely noticed that. Yeah.
Just throws everything off right there. You're like, I had this done. It was good. And no.
Or you just ruined it with your skills of being a waiter.
With your kind customer service.
Now you gotta completely reproportion everything and go back.
Honestly.
And he's like drinking like 4 or 5 big gulps of water. Trying to like get it to the same point. And the waiter's just waiting there with the pitcher like...
Like, I've talked about this with other people, but not to this extent, and really talking about it right now, I'm realizing I definitely have OCD tendencies.
Oh, yeah.
No, you definitely do.
There's no question. Yeah. You fold laundry the same way every time. Who doesn't do that? I just remember playing Overwatch.
And then, like, I didn't, like, mark everything as seed, and you just start freaking out, and I'm just like, why does it matter? Like, it's just
you have to mark it. Like,
yes. I know that.
It doesn't matter.
So, like, when we fold the towels that we, like, dry dishes with or that hang on the, like, handle for the stove, you fold them the same way every time.
Yeah.
Which, that's not a problem because it's just like, oh, it's consistent. But, like, if you and I are folding laundry that we, like, did together, like, and we're folding it together, and I fold one way together. And I hang it on the stove, you will take it off and then refold it in the way that you want, and then just put it back on and not say anything. And I just ignore it because I'm like, you know what? It's not worth having any sort of like discussion, argument, fight, whatever. I'm like, if that's the way he wants it, fine. Let him do it.
What if we ever fold a laundry together?
Fold it. Well, like, we've done like towels and stuff, like your bath towel, mine. And then, like, the two hand towels we have in the bathrooms, and then the kitchen ones, and, the washcloth in the kitchen. Like, when we did a small load or whatever, we're just, like, folding them together or whatever. Like, I'll fold, like, the washcloths, like, in fourths, so, like, in half, and then in half again. But you'll fold them in, like, thirds, and then, like, fold them in half so they're, like, extra small. And I'll sit mine on the pile, and you'll just, like, pick it back immediately, like... Without looking at me saying anything, he'll just pick it up off the done pile, unfold it, and then refold it the way he wants, and sit it back down. And I'm just like, well, why don't you just do the laundry, you know, the misses of the relationship? Because, I mean, I don't care if you do, like, that I grew up that way anyways. Like, the way I folded, you know, whatever was just wrong anyways. So you're just going to redo it. So why try?
That sounds so bad.
It's not, I mean, I'm not mad about it. It's the way it is. And I'm like, whatever. He wants it in a certain way. And I certainly don't care. So whatever.
But yeah, the other weird thing. One, I didn't think it was weird. I thought it was pretty, not productive, but proactive maybe is the right word for me to do. And Ben, like, he saw me do it because we were just talking about whatever we were talking about at the time. And I was packing for a weekend. And he's just in my room as I was packing. And he saw me doing it. He's like, what are you doing? So when I pack, like, and I think this is because I've forgotten a lot of things before. One time I packed, I forgot all my shorts. One time I packed all my underwear. Yeah. So I just forget things. So I'm like, okay, I got to make sure I have everything I need. So say I'm packing for a three-day weekend. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, I need three pairs of underwear, maybe four or five, just in case. Who knows? I need socks, I need shorts, or whatever I need. So when I'm packing, I'll put it all in the bed. And then right before I actually put it in the suitcase, or maybe even after it's in the suitcase, I'll, like, pretend I'm putting all the clothes on. So, like,
right. So no, for real. So, like, what? He'll pretend to get dressed for each day.
Yes.
So, like, he'll put on, like, one, two, three pairs of underwear.
No, not
and then he'll be like,
I'll be like, okay, like, I'll take Friday, okay. One underwear, socks, okay. Shoes, okay.
But it's not just like pants, he kind of talks through t-shirt. It out loud. Like, he goes through the motions. Yeah. Like, he's imagining, like, getting dressed with these imaginary socks and underwear and shirt or hoodie.
You can't just see that it's right there.
Right, like, no, that's where I called him out on that, literally the first
it's
time.
It's literally right in front of you. What are you doing?
Something happened where, like, I don't know if it was after you had just switched or something, like, to a different job. And I was like, oh, where are you going? You're like, oh, I'm going to go, like, spend the weekend with, like, my girlfriend and, like, whatever. I was, like, just talking to you to catch up, and I was sitting in your room, and you're like, you just didn't even say it. You didn't give me any warning. You just were, like, you had your clothes on the bed, and you were, like, you sat on the edge of the bed and, like, pretended to put on, like, imaginary socks, and then, like, stood up and, like, fluffed out your underwear in front of you and, like, stepped into it, like, and then, like, pulled them up and then kind of, like, hopped and, like, pulled them up over your butt.
I didn't hop or do all that.
You did. And then you, like, put on your imaginary pants and did the same thing where you, like, got them up to your knees and then kind of, like, hopped and, like, pulled them up over your, like, your butt. And then you, like, put on the belt and, like, pretended to buckle it. And then you put on your shirt and, like, pulled it over your head. And I was like, what are you doing? And, like, I'm just making sure I'm not forgetting anything. And I was like, are you serious? You can't just count, like, oh, I'm going for 3 days. Or are you, like, okay. three pairs of underwear, three shirts, three pairs of socks. Yeah, right? Like, two pairs of shorts or whatever, you know? Like, and you were like, no, I got to make sure I, like, pretend to put them on so, like, I don't forget anything. And I was like, I was legitimately confused as to why you were doing that. And then eventually I just settled, like, after your long, convoluted, like, pointless, like, explanation, I was just like, okay, whatever works for you, man. And then, like, that's just how you get, like, bland for a weekend, or away, or whatever, or a week.
Yeah, it just,
and you just
works
pretend to put them on. Like, that is probably the weirdest quirk that I have noticed of you, like, living with you. So far, like, yeah, like, walking into the kitchen and, like, making random noises or, like, yelling at me for no reason about whatever stupid thing I'm doing. Like, all of that's fairly normal, but, like, that was probably the weirdest, I would say, like, quirk that I've noticed about you in particular.
That's pretty weird.
I didn't think of that.
So,
that's really weird.
It is. It is pretty
weird.
That's
super weird.
But knowing you, like, now, it's totally within the realm of, like, who you are.
I don't know if I should think that's a compliment.
So, like, looking back, I'm just, like, not surprised at all that, like, that's what you would have done. But experiencing it, like, up front, I was just like, what a freak. What are you doing? So that's one in particular, like, weird thing about you. What is, like, something super weird or odd or whatever, like, maybe not. Maybe I'm the normal one, maybe, of the relationship. But, like, what's the, like, super strange thing that you can think of that I've done that you've noticed? Maybe it's not even something I'm aware of, but, like, that you've just like observed me doing where you're like, is this for real? Like, does he know I'm watching?
Dude, I don't know.
Like, well, like, think about it. Like, I feel like there's definitely something because I know, like, I do some random things that are just, like, weird. Like, especially the whole, like we talked about earlier today or yesterday evening, like, the normal internal monologue that you have with yourself. Like, oh, go here. Like, look in the fridge. Get the milk out.
Okay. Like, well, pour that, it on your cereal. More, that's more something, like, we've talked about, but not something I've noticed.
I generally have that conversation externally with myself. Like, it's not in my head. So I, like, talk through it, like, to,
like,
myself.
Like, if you're home by yourself, do you usually, for me at least, when I'm home by myself, I don't talk. It's more so I'm thinking in my head, oh, let me do this, let me clean that, let me go here and play this game or do whatever.
Yeah,
it's all in my head. And then when someone, when Ben comes home or some friend comes back, I'm like, oh, hey, what's up? And then I realize, wow, I haven't talked all day. Or, like, my voice is, like, really rough because I haven't talked. Mm-hmm. I notice it. I'm like, huh. So Ben was telling me, like, whenever he's home by himself, he will have all those talks and thoughts and out loud.
And I don't think out loud very often.
Like, yeah, like, that is my, so my normal state is like all of those internal thoughts that most people have, like, internally, like the internal monologue or dialogue I have with myself, like, externally. Mm-hmm. Like, I have to be able to hear it to be able to think through, like, to actually achieve whatever the goal is. Like, if it's like make cereal, I'm like, get the bowl out, Ben. Pour the cereal in the bowl. Put the milk on the cereal, like, in the bowl and get the spoon.
With me, it's like, if I'm thinking out loud, it's not anything like that. It's just going to be like, Like, just be like, I was like, okay, what do I want to do today? Do I want to go here?
Yeah.
Go there?
That's more like basic.
Yeah. That's what I say, like most people.
It's like, no, I don't do that.
But, like, I have the full-on, like, internal monologue, like, externally with myself. Mm-hmm. Like, I talk through it, like there's the regular, like, thought Ben, and then there's, like, the other part of Ben that's, like, it's almost like
split personality.
Yeah, but, like, not good job, in a Ben. Negative Thanks, way. Ben. Yeah, exactly. Kind of, but, like, I mean, not, I do that, I not do that as that, a joke. Not but... to that point, but I'm just like, okay, get out, like, the bowl, or like, oh, I need to do this.
See, the
or
only, like, time I'll talk to myself is like,
where's my chapstick? Like, take the lid off, put it on your lips. Like,
I don't know if you, I know you haven't watched How Much Your Mother, have you?
No.
So, like, How Much Your Mother, there's like an episode where they all talk about basically what we're talking about, and it's like almost like a glass breaking moment that they're like, oh my god, you do that, and that's really annoying. But, like, Marshall, one of the characters, he always sings what he does. So he, like, one example was, like, he was, like, doing the laundry. He's, like, taking down the laundry to the basement. And he's just talking and singing. And it's like, yeah, why do you sing everything you do? And they all got really annoyed. I'm like,
that's kind of the way that it works with me, but, like, not the singing part. But, yeah, like if it was just regular dialogue.
Yeah, I'll talk to myself more so, like, oh, let me go ahead and make breakfast right now or something. I don't know. It's something really small, and it ends right there.
Yeah, that's how it was with me. So it's just, like, you say something, it's something really small, really quick, but, like, it's not, like, having, like, a full-on thought conversation thing out with yourself. It's just, like, it's, like, a one thought.
Yeah,
one
no, thing. So, you know, in, to, like, to sum it up very, like, easily, at the beginning of A Bug's Life, where they have that short with the two old men playing chess.
Yeah.
That's me. Like, quite literally, like, if they were talking, like, I'm gonna move my pawn here. That's me.
Alright. Changing gears about this whole Quirk stuff is...
Apparently, I don't do anything that weird that you're
Dude,
like...
I can't think
Ben's
of
Ben's a complete freak because he does this or this.
No, I truly can. If I can
That's kind of amazing, honestly. I'm quite impressed.
Like,
that makes me seem quite normal.
I don't know. So, if something comes up, maybe I'll bring up another episode, but... Changing the gears a little bit, something else I wrote down was, like, weird lies that you believed when you were a kid, and you know they're not true now. Like, if that Santa Claus, or how you found out Santa Claus wasn't real, or if, like, whatever it is. Like, any weird lies like that.
I don't know anything, extremely specific.
Specifically, like, that I can think of, my dad always told my brother and I that he was a Power Ranger. And he always told
that sounds like why him. Does that why does that sound that exactly is not like a surprise dad? At all. Yeah, that sounds exactly yeah.
Like yeah. So he always told us he was a Power Ranger, that he was the purple Power Ranger. Me and my brother were like, there's no purple Power Ranger. What are you talking about? He was like, yeah, there was. Like, but I was so popular, blah, blah, blah. They had to get rid of me. I'm like, no. And me and my brother were like, I honestly don't remember if we truly believed him ever, but like, it was something he told us, and we were little kids. Mm-hmm. And like, it's still something he'll like somewhat bring up even now.
Yeah, yeah.
But like, that's like one thing I can think of on the top of my head. Yeah. Other than
the only thing I think of like top of my head is like, no, it's like the Santa thing where I was literally like, because my dad would dress up as Santa when I was like little, like, okay. And then like, yeah, and then he would like let all the gifts and everything.
I didn't have that, like where someone dressed up.
No,
like,
no, my dad was just, then we came down, me and my sister came down, we're like, Santa? And he's like, we're like, wait, so Santa's not like, black? What are you doing? And he's like, I'm Santa. We're like, you're not Santa. What are you doing? He's like, see me delivering these gifts. We're like,
dude, dad? How many times did your dad have to dress up as Santa Claus and you guys not ever see him?
I know, like, yeah.
That's a lot of effort he had to put in.
Right. So, like, ours was always, and specifically the Christmas thing was like, oh, go to bed, like, so Santa can bring the presents, and, like,
you
it
get was the milk empty cookies out and everything.
When we went to bed, and then we woke up, and it was like, boom, presents. So Santa was there.
Right? Yeah, that's how it was.
That was how
it was. But, like, we kind of always, at least what I remember, but, like, I don't remember super early on, like, we kind of knew, like, it was our parents. And then, like, as I got to be, like, a teenager or whatever, I was like, yeah, no, there's definitely no Santa, but at the same time, I kind of still wanted to believe, and even to this point, it, like, now, I'm, like, almost just, like, no, I want Santa to be real, so I'm just gonna, like, ignore, even if I'm, like, I know 100%, like, it's not, but, like, I just choose to believe in that, because, like, it's just kind of mad, like, this weird, like, magical
thing, yeah,
exactly.
Specifically with Santa, we always like had milk and cookies out, and like when we went to bed, woke up, like some of them were eating. So we're like, oh my god, he came!
Yeah,
I remember the people that lived behind us with like the big pool.
Oh, what'd you find out about?
What?
The people that like live
different
behind...
different people.
Oh, not where your parents are now. Okay,
no, it is, but no, different
people. Yeah. Different people owned it. Okay, never mind.
No, just. It's the house behind us. It's behind us to the left.
Back on topic.
It's the people that live behind us to the left. They have like a bigger pool, not the like the outdoor pool.
Yeah. Okay.
But anyway, they had like reindeer tracks on top of the roof. And I remember one like Christmas Eve. I don't even know if it was Christmas Eve, but they said that they heard a bunch of reindeer on the roof that night. And I remember being up really late. And we like were looking, shining flashlights on, seeing all these tracks, and we were all freaking out about it. So that was really cool. But I remember when I was actually told Santa wasn't real, I think, I don't even know if it was Christmas time at all. Like, it may have been, like, in July. And my mom was making breakfast.
It's like Easter time.
Yeah, like, my mom was making breakfast, and I'm in the family room just watching TV. I guess it was on my mind. I don't know if I was recently watching something. Mm-hmm. I was just like, Mom, is Santa Claus real? And she was like, do you want me to tell you the truth? I was like, yeah. She's like, he's not. I was like, okay.
And that literally and sounds then, like that's how that conversation went.
And then all she said was, are you okay? I'm like, yeah, I think I'm okay. That was it. That's how I found out. Nice. So, yeah.
You know, like, I got, like, where it was, like, I remember one person, I don't remember, like, it was Christmas Eve. And I just remember we heard, like, some Christmas bells, like, ringing. Like, just, like, it was, like, and it was, like, maybe, like, 1, 2 a.m. And we're just like, oh, it's the reindeer. They're coming. Whatever. And it was like the only time I've ever heard that noise, like almost ever in my life. Where it's like, I don't know if this was like actually like a dream or if it was like actually happened.
Mm-hmm.
But then I talked to like my sister the next day, and she's like, no, that I don't know what you're talking about. This didn't happen.
So either she was really asleep or it was a dream.
Yeah. I was like, like the reindeer, they're here. And then like she was like, what are you talking about? Like there's no reindeer. I'm like, no, you can't, like, and that was like you literally saw last year, like Dad was Santa Claus, like or like a year or two ago, like Dad was Santa, there's no such thing. I'm like, wait, what? No Santa? That's kind of how it got broken to me.
Right.
I'm just like, oh.
Real fast. Yeah, that's gonna do it for this one, everyone. Thanks for listening. I've been Avery.
I'm Ben.
I'm Justin.
And Mandy's asleep on the couch. But thanks for listening, everyone. And you can find us on all the major podcast sites, Spotify, Google Play Music, iTunes, Stitcher, whatever else you listen on. And hopefully you guys are having a fantastic day. And we'll talk to you guys later.